An expert spent the last 24 hours fact-checking and breaking down all that was said during Tuesday night's presidential debate. One America's Caitlin Sinclair has more on their list of top moments.
Larry, you have a unique communications and political background, and I know our viewers are going to want to tap into that after watching last night's debate. So let's dive right in. President Trump stated that this city here in New York might never recover from the economic collapse caused by the pandemic. He said, "I am not sure it can ever recover." Now, we all know what the president means by this comment goes much deeper than the pandemic itself. The fallout is due to some of our elected officials here, like Governor Cuomo, and their policies that were put in place during this pandemic. Of course, we saw Vice President Biden chuckling at this remark, but this is serious for New Yorkers. What kind of picture, Larry, can we paint for our viewers when we imagine Joe Biden as our leader trying to get us out of this economic crisis when he has already said he wants to keep the economy locked down?
Well, you're right. He wants to lock down the American economy. He said he's going to do that. He would immediately lock down the economy again. And then he keeps talking about, well, President Trump is not allowing schools to reopen. Well, he's not allowing schools to, he's not in charge of allowing schools to reopen. That's the state and the cities. And quite frankly, the president has done a great job with PPE, making sure that every hospital and every school has what it needs. It's not a matter of the PPE. It's a matter of these leftist politicians politicizing COVID to keep our country locked down. And he's right. New York may never recover.
Now, of course, we also heard Biden try to blame our president for the anarchy in Democratic-run cities that we've been seeing the past 5 to 6 months. Now, for the New Yorkers that sent me personal messages, Larry, this was the most troubling for them to hear, being that our city has been burning and destroyed. During these same exact months, these Democrats have ignored or excused the chaos that has engulfed our cities. Biden's own running mate, you know this, Kamala Harris, she went so far as to raise bail money for those arrested during the riots in Minnesota. The looting, the burning of our cities has gone completely unmentioned. Even at the DNC, we saw that. So now, instead of ignoring the violence, blaming the president is the strategy. You saw last night, President Trump, he reminded us that he offered to step in and help. And I really want your help in making this point. In our federal system of government, the president has to either wait for governors to ask him for help or override them by invoking the Insurrection Act. That law has been used by a dozen presidents to put down violence. But when President Trump suggested he might use the law, Democrats then accused him of wanting to use the U.S. military to crush so-called peaceful protests. Larry, how is a former vice president going to stand on that stage, a former VP who knows that the system works? How is he still able to try and blame President Trump?
You made a great point. And look, Biden was given an opportunity to answer the question, when did you call Portland? When did you call the mayor of Portland and say, hey, look, knock this nonsense off. Let's stop the violence. The mayor of Portland would listen to, remember what Joe Biden said last night, I am the Democratic Party. That means he's the leader of the party that's running the city in Portland. He's the leader that's running the city in Chicago. And in Minnesota, he's the leader of the party that's running all of this chaos and anarchy in these cities into the ground.
Exactly. So if the next moderator wants to ask what has allowed the violence to continue unchecked for months, the answer really should be the refusal of Democratic state and local officials to accept the president's offer to help quell it.
You're absolutely right. Look, Biden tried to tie Kyle Rittenhouse to white supremacists. And I just saw a tweet come over that said his attorney is looking into not only for him to retract that statement, which is completely false, but that he may be suing the vice president, the former vice president, for slander.
Yeah, and you bring up a great point. Just for our viewers' knowledge, this was after Biden released a video suggesting that Rittenhouse is a, quote, white supremacist. Biden's video accused President Trump of refusing to condemn white supremacists, which he actually did, and included footage of Rittenhouse in Kenosha. Of course, there is no public evidence that Rittenhouse is a white supremacist.
Thank God, because somebody's got to stand up for this nonsense. It's not the president's fault.
It is time we all stand up for truth. You would think that's the least we can do as our great country's democracy is at stake here. Thank you for helping us to break some of this down, Larry.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.